My name's Tom Gazda. I teach an applied physics class in high school to 12th graders. And one of the things that we do every year, I have this lab called the Brad Lab, named after this kid Brad. And it's basically measuring in our school, it's like a rectangular shape around the inside of the school. How far around is it around the this area of the school? I want students to measure it with ways that don't involve traditional using a tape measure, so come up with different ways. One of the ways that was suggested this year, because we had previously learned what the speed of sound was, which is 761 miles per hour, one of our students, Alex, suggested that we use the speed of sound to measure the distance. And after that kind of got shelled, but after we were done with the other methods, we kind of went back and looked at using the speed of sound. The ability to record slow motion, which is now on most people's phones, you have an iPhone, you can record 240 frames per second slow motion. So using that has really gave us the ability to look at the difference in the speed of sound as it travels throughout the hall. So we've done a bunch of trials and we've troubleshooted it along the way. It's been a great process. I think we have pretty good data, pretty good measurements, but it turns out that every time we calculate it, we're off by sometimes close to 20%. And we're still working hard on trying to figure out why that is. So I put this video together to try to show people what we've been doing. One of the things we thought was the source of our trouble was when you clap the blocks together, when exactly do they come together? When exactly is the sound created? And it gets hard to tell, especially when you really slow it down. So we were brainstorming some ideas of how to use other methods that are maybe more clear when the sound is created. We have a few ideas. The one that we tried, and I have a video of it that I'm going to show, is popping a balloon. So I'm going to show this now. So we have really brainstormed a lot about this. We've done a lot of good problem solving. Really proud of the class in general. You know, real problem solving is not something that you get to do in high school. It gets talked about, but you don't really get to do it. And we've done it in this class, and the kids have been great. So I'm really excited about that. But we're dedicated, and I know I'm particularly dedicated, to try to really get this close, to really get a slow measurement error, because I think we should be able to. So we reach out. The assignment here is for have students help us reach out to some experts who maybe can push us in the right direction, or at least can maybe suggest what our source of error is, so that we can then try to problem solve to account for that and to reduce that. So thanks for your time. Really appreciate it.